Shalom and blessings, warriors of Yahuwah and the truth. Good afternoon. Oh, Beanie. I'm going to continue on with the lessons from the return of Yahusha. The beginning is near. We are on video 4. Bella. No licking books. Okay. We are on the secret of Elohim is ending. Yahuwah allowed Yasharal to be sifted among the Gentiles over many centuries, but he will gather Yasharal back to his Torah from among the pagans and not forget or lose a single one of us, of those he has chosen. It's happening now. This has also been his secret. His promise to do this is for all those Gentiles on whom his name is called. He's Yasharal's husband. Amos 9:12, Acts 15:17, and Ephesians 3:1 through 10. Andrew's nightmare. One night, brother Andrew had a dream. He was fishing by the side of the lake, and his brother Kepha and friends Yaakov and Yehukanan drifted up in a little boat. Shalom, Kepha. It's been quite a night, Andrew called to them. What's with the bubbles and all the gear? It's not Purim already, is it? He asked. Kepha replied in a scornful tone of voice. Sorry. That's Reverend Kepha to you, Andrew. I'll not have you addressing me in such a profane manner. Yaakov, Yahusha's brother, piped in. And I'll be Rabbi Yaakov from now on, and this is Pastor Yehukanan. Dig? Otherwise, you can call us Father if you wish. Andrew was stunned at the change in these formerly humble men. It made him feel very low, unimportant, and unloved. He said in a faint, hesitant voice, "Where have you been for the last several months? I've missed you all." Kepha said, "We've been studying at Rome, and now we have the whole rank and file worked out. We've adopted the patterns of the Kaiser's religious council due to its efficiency and absolute control." Stop, Roscoe. "We're pig-eating Sunday worshippers now, calling ourselves Christians. Help us with this monstrance." Sorry. The next section is, our thoughts are different from Yahuwah's thoughts. A jubilee is a 50-year period of time, as described by Scripture. It is divided into weeks of years, and as we see referred to in the words of Daniel, making up 7 weeks for each jubilee. Then the 50th year of release, debts, lands, slaves. Everything is reset in the 50th year. Another type of clock, which has recorded each year faithfully, appears to be the rings in the oldest trees found on earth. The oldest trees still appear to be growing like they are young adolescents, adding to their mass each year. None are older than around 4,300 years old. What happened about 4,348 years ago? The single thing that seems to have wiped out all the previous trees and marked the new beginning for their seed appears to be the great flood of Noah's day. As recorded by the first of 5 scrolls attributed to Musa or Moses. Stop, Roscoe, a descendant of Shem. The flood seems to have reset the record in the tree rings, but when a person wishes to overlook this record, and other enigmas remain. Roscoe, go! If we choose to accept that nature randomly experimented and blundered into producing a fully functional eyeball, or rather a pair of them, there would need to be vastly more evidence in the fossil record of blind creatures with varying degrees of eyeball development. thus proving that this happened. Yet there is no evidence of any such thing found. All organs in all forms of life seem to have appeared abruptly and fully functional. We are going to have to ask our evolutionist friends for those blobbier, half-developed organisms to be presented from the fossilized materials, and this should not be any problem for them at all, if it really happened the way they believe it did. Nature could not have hidden all her experiments from us. Such experiments and failures would have to outnumber the successes by far. Philosophies pertaining to evolution are easily debunked by men of true science today, especially those who have thoroughly studied the issues. Many unbelieving men who were at one time evolutionists have crossed over to a faith in a creator as a result of testing the theories of evolution. Their former evolutionist peers shun them if they become vocal of their discoveries. Roscoe, go! Go, go, go! Okay, sorry about that, guys. No, Roscoe, down! Okay, I'm just trying to get this so he can't get back here. Go! Okay, so I was at the part about, I'm gonna have to turn this sideways again today. I apologize. Okay, there we go. I'm sorry, guys. Okay, so many of you reading this book have had a similar experience. By personally studying scripture and testing what you have been taught by the traditional establishment, to expose the falsehoods and sham our religious culture practices will cause our former peers to shun us. We are sent to them and awakened for them, not for our sake only. We mustn't look for others like ourselves, but teach them so they will be like us and see the truth. In the pages ahead, we are going to expose the power structure of the strongest and long-lived entity on Earth. Sorry, guys. Not only will its system of authority be easily exposed, but you will also see how incredibly weak and foolish it will appear when its imaginary clothing is ripped away from it. Prophecy is being fulfilled. Roscoe, stop. How the beast controls the world order. There are three estates, clergy, nobility, and laity, or commoners. Now the media is considered a fourth estate. This beast reflects the spiritual principalities of authority, the plan for total control over society. The seven sacraments, maybe? When we think about the corporation called the Roman Catholic Circus, or Church, we should also recall the Eastern Orthodox Church and how these two split. They basically excommunicated one another, 1378 to 1417, because both of their respective heads declared themselves to be the CEO or Pope. See Great Schism or Schism. Today we see a Western Mediterranean head and an Eastern head, the kingdom divided against itself. Sorry, Bella. At the core of these organizations, there is a central doctrine or teaching that everything is built upon, and without it, they would be unable to function. Roscoe, go! You're bugging her! The method by which they operate is this, the laity, or common people. Roscoe, formerly illiterate in past, hold on. Roscoe! Stop. I forgot, I lost my place, I'm sorry, guys. And without it, they would be unable to function. Okay, the laity, formerly illiterate in past centuries, were told that the priests were blessed with supernatural powers and abilities. Roscoe, you're dropping crap. Stop. Not nice. I apologize. Bellish. The priests were blessed with supernatural powers and abilities. That's what they were told, anyway. Roscoe, leave her alone. Sorry. And through these men, grace could be dispensed or given out. Grace was administered by means of seven sacraments. Each sacrament was only to be able to be received through one of the ordained priests of these Catholic organizations. Grace was loosely defined as something that could be distributed as a commodity, some invisible magic jelly. Roscoe, stop. This grace was and is thought to be the presence of the J-Man, really Yahusha, and his subsequent forgiving love. Many times this love and presence had to be begged through his mother in prayer and offerings, but going to the priest to receive one of the sacraments would be a direct way to force this invisible magic jelly to be delivered upon demand. I'll let them explain the sacraments to you. They just make this stuff up and the public believes them. A sacrament is an outward sign instituted by CHRIST to give grace. Roscoe, she's going to fall. But not evidenced by any scripture somehow. The church is, or the circus itself is a sacrament instituted by CHRIST to give grace. J-Man gave us his apostles and his church to minister the seven sacraments to help us lead a good life in this world and to help us reach him in the afterlife. Human traditions, no scripture. As they, the sacraments, evolved from the earliest traditions of the church, the Eastern and Roman Catholic, as well as the Eastern Orthodox churches, all recognize the seven sacraments of baptism, confirmation, Holy Eucharist, penance, and the anointing of the sick, holy orders and matrimony, signs and wonders, confirmation or chrismation is the sacrament which gives the Holy Spirit, Ruach HaKodesh. See more at www.cathworld.org. Dispensing these sources of grace through the RCC corporate priestcraft is the operation of the entire Catholic organism. These are the traditions from which all Christians have their doctrinal roots, and this book puts them on display for you to evaluate. Our purpose is to restore the true roots of the original faith. The secret of lawlessness is already at work. Only until he who now restrains or controls comes out of the midst. And then the lawless one shall be revealed, whom the master shall consume with the spirit of his mouth and bring to naught with the manifestation of his coming. The coming of the lawless one is according to the working of Satan with all power and signs and wonders of falsehood and with deceit of unrighteousness in those perishing because they did not receive the love of the truth in order for them to be saved. And for this reason, Elohim sends them a working of delusion for them to believe the falsehood in order that all should be judged who did not believe the truth, but have delighted in the unrighteousness. 2 Thessalonians 2, 7 through 12. I'll do one more. The next section is false witnesses. Many who teach erroneous religious doctrines are false witnesses, teachers of error, because they deny the covenant made with Yasharal and excuse their teachings of disobedience to it by claiming not to be Yasharal but Gentiles. That's a crude way to look at it. I don't even Gentiles engraft into the vine, and that is how we become what they call legalists, but we are Nazarene. We're not legalists. Like, I mean, if we want to follow the commandments, why would they call us legalists? We're not, we don't, like, it's not like we want to follow the rules of the world. We want to follow Yahuwah's rules. Yahuwah's commandments. Roscoe, go! Oh, sorry, guys. Okay. We find from scripture that all who are not of Yasharal must engraft and become Yasharal. Romans 11. The rules and teachings don't change at all. But somehow believing they do makes the hearers feel comfortable and even superior because they claim J-Man as their savior. They also have been taught that Yahuwah is three persons, yet one Elohim. That is not possible. In any way you look at it, it's not, in physics, it's not possible. Go, Roscoe. And I don't even study physics, and I know that. You believe that Elohim is one, you do well. The demons also believe and shudder. Jacob or James 2:19. Roscoe, stop. This is what I've been dealing with for the last week. I wish somebody would want him. Like, it's too hard to handle him going after little Bella. If somebody has another big dog and they want a Rottweiler, Roscoe is for sale. And I'm sorry I'm interrupting Yahuwah's word for this, but he's been interrupting me all week long. And he won't stop jumping behind the flag. Sorry, guys. It's just very irritating. You're making her sneeze. Go! Okay. There are six things which Yahuwah hates. Yes, seven which are an abomination to him. Roscoe, you're going to make her fall. Haughty eyes, a lying tongue, and hands that shed innocent blood, a heart that devises wicked purposes, feet that are swift in running to mischief, a false witness that utters lies, and he that sows discord among brethren. Proverbs 6:16-19. A new commandment I give to you, that you love one another, even as I have loved you, that you also love one another. By this shall all men know that you are my disciples, if you have loved one another. Yehukanan 13:34-35. It's okay for us to be discerning of teachings, and we must make judgments concerning them according to what Scripture teaches. We cannot judge the outcome of people themselves because we don't know when or if they will get knocked down and straightened out by Yahusha. We are told to love both our brethren and our enemies. I said you could clean your ears. I didn't say you could soak them. Go. Even a beginner in the faith can determine that the methods used by Catholicism were based on gross misunderstandings. Catholicism itself was the Roman state religion instituted by Constantine, not Yahusha or the apostles. This system of dispensing grace through its priesthood grew so large and powerful that it was able to influence every nation it came into contact with. The Roman calendar became the church calendar and kept its Latin names for the months, about half of which are named for Roman deities. But the secret of lawlessness, which denies and conceals the true message of the renewed covenant, is today being exposed and revealed. The one who is doing this revealing is Yahusha. The spirit of Yahusha is in us, guiding us into all truth. He is the one who will reveal the lawless one. He is the one in the midst of the seven assemblies of Nazarene. Next time, my next lesson will be on blasphemy against the Ruach, the secret of lawlessness, the seven assemblies of Revelation, and I think that's as far as I'll be able to get for the next lesson. I'm trying to shorten my lessons for you guys. Roscoe, you're making her choke. Okay. So, Yahuwah Baruch you all. Baruch Abba Vashem Yahuwah. I love you all. Shalom. Roscoe.